Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to learn how to enable virtualization in Windows 11. Virtualization is a powerful tool that lets you run multiple operating systems on a single computer. This can be incredibly useful for developers, testers, or anyone who wants to experiment with different software without affecting their main system. So stick around and let's do this. But before we get started, let's check if your system even supports virtualization. Okay, so to check this, you need to press Windows plus R keys to open the run application on your Windows PC. And here you have to type msinfo32 and hit OK. Here you need to search for the virtualization based security. You can see it showing not enabled. So another way we can check, for that you need to open the Task Manager. You can do this by right clicking the Start menu and click on Task Manager. Now you need to click on the Performance tab. Under the CPU sections, look for virtualization. If it says enable, you are good to go. And if it says disable, then you need to follow the steps in the video to enable this. Okay. Now let's head into the BIOS or UEFI setting to enable virtualization. For that, first we need to click on Start, then click on Settings. Once the setting page will open, in the left hand side you will find System. Click on this. Now you need to scroll down and look for Recovery. Here click on Restart Now besides Advanced Startup. Okay. So now once your PC restart, you should see an options that display choose an option. From here, click on troubleshoot. Then click on advanced option. After that, click the UEFI firmware setting options. Now you need to click on restart to change the UEFI settings. Okay. Once the BIOS setup page will open, here look for the virtualization settings. The specific names might differ slightly depending on your BIOS. So in my Dell laptop, it's on virtualization support. So I need to click on this and look for settings like virtualization technology, VT, and you need to enable this along with VT for direct IO. After that, click on apply changes to save your BIOS settings. And then click on exit. Now your computer will restart. After restart, you need to enable the virtualization in Windows features. Okay, so for that, click on start and search for Windows features. Once the turn Windows features on or off will open, scroll down and find the virtual machine platform checkbox. Make sure it's checked. And click OK. Windows will install the necessary components now. You can see. This might take a few minutes. Once finished, you need to restart your computer. Now the time to verifying virtualization is enabled or not. So for that, the same way, open the Task Manager again and go to the Performance tab. Under the CPU section, virtualization should now display enable. See? So this is how you have successfully enabled virtualization in Windows 11. Okay, so that's it. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comments below. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more tech tutorials and tips. Thanks for watching.